Enterprise Development Authority, Elam's large potential. Entrepreneurial reawakening is yet another step forward by NEDA to create a support, encourage, and facilitate enterprise development within Sri
Lanka. So I have communicated this message to the Asian Development Bank, have come here and sit together for 2 days at Jai Hilton to develop SME Innovation Accelerator. So the program is attended by veteran professionals in our country as well as overseas. So therefore,
I also request Honorable Vishal Badruddin, Minister of Industry and Commerce, to present a copy of the newsletter to former Minister Honorable Rohita Bogolagama, who presented the NEDA Act to Parliament way back in 2005 on the 21st of December.
The purpose of this platform is to share with young entrepreneurs knowledge about the services which are offered to them on a daily basis by a number of stakeholders within the country. It's a platform which is meant to be sort of a marketplace between service providers and young entrepreneurs in need of support. It's a platform which is meant to be a place to exchange information amongst young people and young entrepreneurs and experts. There's going to be, as you will see, a specific forum for this purpose. Last but not least, this platform is a tool to coordinate the effort under the leadership and guidance of NEDA of all the business services providers. There are a wealth of them within this country, and some of them without this country, but providing and catering to Sri Lankan entrepreneurs. Through this platform, we wish to have a better and coordinated services to the benefit.
Systematically aware of them, especially youth. The platform aims to address such issues by becoming the reference virtual space, facilitating the match between demand and the supply of business support services, while representing a place where young entrepreneurs can find answers to their problems through localized and tailored support. In Sri Lanka, although a middle-income country, the unemployment rate among youth was about 20, much higher than overall unemployment rate above 4%, and also high in comparison with that of the youth unemployment rate in South Asia, which stands about 10%. In Sri Lanka, looking at relations between education levels and unemployment, it appears that the higher the educational level amongst the youth, the higher the probability of being unemployed. ILO has initiated programs globally, also in Sri Lanka, to support the government, to support employers and trade union organizations to promote the youth employment, premised upon the four E's, namely through promoting equality in access to decent work, strengthening the employability.
Everybody, put your hands together for a round of applause, and we officially unveil this very important web portal, ye.lk.
Dr. Sunil Navaratne, former chairman NEDA, and my senior consultant of our ministry, and Mr. Ashutosh Naviratna, acting secretary of our ministry, Mr. Srinivardhana, advisor to the ministry, Mr. Lakshman, director NEDA, and other officials from NEDA, all other distinguished invitees, friends from media, ladies and gentlemen. Firstly, I extend my thanks to NEDA and the International Labour Organization, ILO, and all other stakeholders for inviting me to this event today. During today's new initiative called as Entrepreneurial Reawakening, Business a Better Tomorrow for the London Entrepreneur, which is aimed at engaging our youth, we also launched NEDA's Doing Business Guidebook, a newsletter for entrepreneurs, as well as a special web portal for youth entrepreneurs of Sri Lanka. These efforts could not have been possible without the valuable support of International Labour Organization officers in Colombo. And I thank and commend ILO's pioneering assistant to the NEDA under our ministry for this effort. I commend former Minister Rohit Bogolagama for joining us today. NEDA was born under his guidance. I have to thank Dr. Sunil Navaratne, former chairman of NEDA, as special advisor on coordinating our NEDA and other state institutions under my ministry. He was a chairman for a short period. During this short period, he has strengthened NEDA in great way. The economic reform initiatives of the unity government of His Excellency the President Maithripala Sirisena and Honorable Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe are now being put into action step by step. It is important for us to understand that these measures become more practical when the youth of the country are also made a stakeholder in them. Therefore, there is an urgent need to encourage our youth towards this, and we believe that on effective ways engaging them to entrepreneurship and SMEs, which is an important sector of our economy. As a lower middle income country, we all understand the important role of SMEs in our economy. According to the government's latest data, Sri Lanka's SME base consists a little more than 1 million on the enterprises in total. 92% of them are micro scale enterprises. 50% of medium scale establishments are in urban areas, while 74% of micro establishments are in rural areas. Small and medium scale businesses tend to be in service sector, while most micro enterprises tend to be in trade sector. Though 92% of SMEs are micro scale enterprises, their employment generation capacity is very low, at only 30% of the total SME employment. An interesting pattern is the registration of SMEs. The lowest registered number of micro and small enterprises are reported from Puttalam district, while the highest number of registered micro and small enterprises are found in an unexpected place, the Kilinochi district. Though most of Lankan youth are increasingly engaging in Facebook and YouTube, the number of youth entrepreneurs do not show such increase, which is discouraging. NEDA estimates Lankan youth engaging in SMEs to be a low percentage of only 15 and a maximum of 20% of total youth workforce. Therefore, this initiative attempts to increase youth engagement in entrepreneurship through their most common platform, the internet. Sri Lanka's present internet user total is a little more than 4.2 million. In year 2014, the internet usage grew by 9%. Use of online services such as Facebook, YouTube, etc. by Lankan youth is a major contributor driving this steady increase. The online web portal launched today by NEDA for our youth is in three languages and functions as a one-stop online shop to collect the exchange information and business support services for the Lankan youth. The NEDA and our ministry supports, encourages and facilitates enterprise development within Sri Lanka with special attention to the micro, small and medium enterprise sector of the country. In 2015, NEDA conducted a business development services fair and even two steps to develop women entrepreneurs. This year, NEDA has completed 885 trainings, launched entrepreneurship development programs with universities among its important development initiatives. And today, for the first time, NEDA is entering to support the youth of the country through a single committed project. Finally, I thank ILO again and my former chairman, short period CEO, sir, Chairman NEDA, Mrs. Himali Dinadasa. Now she is Director General, Export Development Board. She also worked hard to bring this project with ILO. For this support towards NEDA and my ministry, and wishing good luck for this initiative. I also wish you all a pleasant day. Thank you.